subscribe to Nykaa TV and press the bell icon to make sure you never miss an update from us.
I'm sure everyone agrees that when it comes to makeup, there are no rules. It's for anyone and everyone who wants to enhance their appearance. But when it comes to mature skin, it can be a little tricky to work with. Hi everyone, I'm Deepal Haria and welcome to the Mature Skin series, wherein I'll be showing you everything that can help you ace your makeup skills when it comes to mature skin. So for today, I'm going to show you how you can prep your skin and do your base makeup that can help you give a perfect canvas to do your makeup look. So let's begin. Always remember that the secret to flawless makeup and skin is skin prep. So whether you're 18 or 50, that really does not matter. I think skincare is something you should totally invest in. So today, I'm going to start with using the Farsali oil. So to begin with, I'm going to apply a few drops on her face. All you need to do is massage the oil into the skin, and you can always take it in an upward direction. This hydrates the skin really well. So I feel after a certain age, the skin loses its moisture and elasticity. So to bring that back, you need to use something which will help you blur out the fine lines and the wrinkles. The next product I'm using is the Algorithm Wrinkle Filler. I'm using my ring finger to apply this because it has the least amount of pressure. You can apply it all over the eye. I feel like a nourishing cream is very important as the area around the eye is extremely thin and sensitive. So this also hydrates it and blurs out the wrinkles and fine lines. And it's very important so that the concealer can set in perfectly well. Next, I'm going to take the L'Oreal Paris Hydra Fresh Genius Moisturizer. This is a water-based moisturizer. Usually after a certain age, the skin can become a little dry and a little boost of hydration does not hurt, right? This hydrates the skin very nicely and leaves the skin very fresh. And don't forget to also apply some on the neck. So we are going to leave this for about 2 minutes and then move on to our next step. Next, I'm moving on to one of my favorite products, that is the Benefit Professional Primer. This is every makeup artist's cult product. So let's get started with using the primer. I'm just going to take a pea-sized amount on my fingers and apply wherever I feel that there are wrinkles and pores, also fine lines. This helps in blurring them out. Next, I'm moving on to the concealer, and for the concealer, I'm using the Nykaa Skin Genius Conceal and Correct Palette. Usually, there's a lot of discussion and debate about using the concealer before foundation or after foundation, but I personally like to use it before the foundation, especially for mature skin, because I feel the foundation will look less patchy if you do that. So, for her under eyes, I'm going to use very little corrector, and I'm using the orange corrector for the same. Taking some orange corrector under the eyes, and if you feel that the skin has pigmentation, you can take it there as well. But I feel like for her, you only need it under the eyes. And then I'm going to use a flesh tone to brighten up the under eyes. So after using the brush, I'm going to take my fingers, and this is going to help me blend out the concealer well. Also, I feel that an orange corrector is a magical color because it can hide any sorts of dark circles or pigmentation on your skin. I'm done with concealing her under eyes, and you can actually see the difference, and her face looks so much more brighter and fresh. For the foundation, I'm going to use the Maybelline Superstay Foundation in the shade 128 and 130. I'm mixing both of them because I want the perfect shade to come on her skin. I'm going to swatch it on her jawline and check whether the shade is right. I feel like this is blending in her skin really well, so I'm going to go for this one. I'm using a foundation brush, just applying a little on her face and blending it out in circular motions again. make sure that you're applying the foundation all over face and in every corner of a face. Sometimes we tend to miss out the corners of the nose, the eyes, ears, neck. So it's very important to cover every area very well. I completely believe in less is more, because the more you apply something, the fine lines and the wrinkles can show even more. So apply as less as possible, and if that is brightening up the face, then nothing like it. So if you want, you can gradually build it up instead of applying it all at once. Some of the ears and neck as well. So as you see, while I'm applying the foundation with the brush, I'm always going in circular motions, and that's how you need to go about it. Next, I'm taking a damp beauty blender on the skin and lightly dabbing it. I love using the beauty blender because I feel like the excess product comes out and the foundation sinks in well in the skin. Next, I'm moving on to the powder. I'm using the Huda Beauty Easy Bake Loose Powder. It's very important to apply a loose powder after the foundation because it will lock the foundation and set it very well. For her skin, I'm going to take very little and just brush it all over her face and apply a little under the eyes because that's where I've done the concealer. And I feel like this gives a very seamless canvas in the end. While I'm applying the powder, as you see, I'm slightly dabbing it because I want it to go inside the skin and not pop out. Another reason to apply the powder is because I do not want my foundation or concealer to move. Contouring can be a quick fix for instantly lifting up your face, because sometimes after a certain age, the skin loses its elasticity and starts drooping. So for the contouring, I'm going to use the Makeup Revolution Ultra HD Contour Palette. As you see that there are so many colors in a contour palette, but all you can do is take any color which is two shades darker than her skin tone, take it lightly on the brush. Don't forget to remove the excess. I'm going to do the contouring only for her cheeks and her jawline. I'm not taking it on the forehead. You can take some on the nose as well. You can start it from the top and bring it up to the end of her eye. Very lightly brush it. When you move on to the jawline, you can start from the corner of her ear and take it till the center. I'm doing the contouring because I want her features to look sharper and enhance them even more. Before I did the contouring, the foundation and the powder made the face look very flat. So I love doing the contouring because it lifts the face even more. And slightly brush it out. Make sure that you don't leave any lines. I'm just gonna take some on my fingers for the nose. Start from the corner and take it up to the eyebrows. Again, do not leave any lines. As soon as you see any, just blend it out. So again, the nose can look much more sharper if you're doing the contouring in the right way. So if I feel like this certain part is bulging out, I can cut that. And you can actually press the powder well in these areas. And slightly take it up to give a complete finish. Also applying a little on the tip. Once I'm done, I'm taking the brush again and blending it. My entire base is done, and in the end, I'm going to use the NYX setting spray and spray it all over her face just to give more freshness and hydration. While you're applying the setting spray, make sure you're keeping enough distance from the face and just lightly spray it all over. And that's it, I'm done. Fine lines call for fine detail, and a good base is very important for flawless makeup application. If you have any questions, you can ask me in the comment box. I'll be there to answer them. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Nykaa TV for lots more. Tune in to our next video where I'll be showing you an Indian festive look on mature skin.